Ladies and gentlemen, before we get to the next episode of Thunder Buddies, I would like to just take a brief moment here and tell you all that on Friday, August 27th, at the Watervliet Dome, the International Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame and New York Championship Wrestling have come together to give you one of the biggest shows of the summer in the 518 area, and it just so happens that our very own The Stepdads will be facing off against none other than the Hall of Famers themselves, the Rock and Roll Express. You are not going to want to miss this tag team dream match. Tickets start at $25, and you can head over to brownpapertickets.com right now to pick up a copy of yours. See you in the ring. This is our fourth episode of Thunder Buddies. We have Wade Krueger and Radley Belmont, the Stepdads, as you may know. And we are going to keep going with the journey here.
By episode four, I really hope they know who we are. Or that's really confusing.
This is Thunder 4, A New Hope.
Here is the intro to Thunder right here.
Most important.
So they didn't keep that original intro long at all.
1 month.
A month.
First pay-per-view done. The production value is so much higher on this, too.
Wow.
It looks so much better.
I wouldn't be surprised if they just weren't ready.
It was like, I guess it's maybe they treated the first month like a pilot.
Yeah.
Oh, that's set. We got a new set. And it looks like a Mega Man stage. We got air ducts for John McClane to pop out of. We got random powers of both of them.
The new look of Thunder. If I saw this as a kid, I would just assume the show would change every month after the pay-per-view.
Yeah.
I wonder if WWE still has, like, the original set and all that stuff.
Like The Rock? No.
Probably not. I want them Rock aprons, man.
Dude. I ain't kidding.
So one thing I wish they kept. So hello, Tony and Bray. This is the first time we're going to see Big Kev, Big Sexy, the Giant Killer, since J.J. Dillon had him taken out of the arena. As long as Tiger Lee's here, I'm happy.
You have to admire J.J. Dillon. He said, and he did exactly what he said he was going to do, and we're going to hear from J.J. Dillon later on tonight.
Once again, Bobby, just realizing he's on the set of Thunder, a little disappointed.
Yeah.
He shows up to Thunder every day hoping it's Nitro.
Well, Eric Bischoff is trying to be the peacemaker here. He's trying to keep everybody copacetic, but with Savage the Loose Cannon, Eric, you
I do love having the audience behind the announcers. I wish WWE did that. I think, to me, it's like the greatest way to set up a weekly show is just to have the announcers talk a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know why they don't do that.
it takes 2 minutes.
And WWE could, because they have the fans behind the announcers still, even though they're at ringside.
Man, they are still packed. People still think Thunder's a big deal to go to, huh?
And they're in Nashville.
Yeah, Mid-South Coliseum. This is Jerry Lawler's Coliseum, essentially.
Oh, and we're opening up hot with Sick Boy.
Is this going to be one of the, like, four Sick Boy matches ever on television?
I mean, it looks like it. But he's coming out.
The bell hasn't rung yet. The bell hasn't rung yet. It might not be a match.
And he is coming out first, and you know what that means? We're in Memphis, Tennessee. He could not be in the match at all. A member of Raven's Flock makes its way in. This
crowd is going to erupt here in just a second. Yeah, we're about getting ready to see one of the guys that really is embraced.
If you've been watching along with us, you know that sometimes when you come out first, then someone comes out second, and then someone comes out third, and then that's between the second and third guys.
Anything's possible on Thunder. US Heavyweight
Championship. Take a look at this guy, Sick Boy.
You could have a promo. The man's got some talent. The man's you could either take ability. The match, or you could take the mystery box. A rookie in the sport. And the mystery box could be anything. It could even be a match.
Alright, so, fun fact. This is how much of a WCW nerd I am. I saw this match in the last year, because I just wanted to know if Sick Boy ever actually had a singles match, and I looked it up.
Awesome.
And it was this one. So I saw this match in the last year.
I'm sorry. We'll find out afterwards, I guess.
You should be. I wasted a whole work break on that match.
Is it worth watching?
And I'm gonna watch it again now.
It's a match.
It's definitely a match.
But since that, the fans have really just flocked around this man. They love him. They appreciate his work ethic. And now that he's U.S. heavyweight champion, we're talking about
once again, this is the DDP I always think of when I think of DDP.
Let's also bring up the fact it was just a couple of Thursdays ago here on TBS Thunder. We saw Hollywood Hulk Hogan take a crush to DDP's already injured.
Anytime DDP has the ribs taped up, that feels like prime DDP to me.
Well, that's what was so cool about DDP was his character was that he never healed. He wrestled so much that he never actually healed his ribs. And I thought that was such a cool idea that I've never seen before or since.
I'm pretty sure it's even one of his players in the video game that has to take ribs.
Yeah.
He's close to the rest of the flock, and they're always together. All of them are always together.
The only other thing I could think of was D-Row with the, like, Kevlar.
Right,
but
and that was on the heel.
For an advantage after a while, yeah.
I love this idea, though, just to have a guy constantly wear a bandage or something just to get over. Almost sympathetic, but not, because he's being tough about it.
It blends the balance between sympathy and toughness. Like, it automatically makes you want to root for him. Even if you've never seen him before, you're like, oh, my goodness. I root for him.
And it's a great hidden excuse for every time he loses, too. He doesn't have to say it, but it's a good excuse. Into the ropes he goes,
picks him up! Oh,
nice. Oh, by the way, Sick Boy's
Sick Boy.
Diamond
Dallas Page, spectacular move, and the fans are up here at the Mid-South Coliseum. I think anybody who knows Diamond Dallas Page
is so aware that the Diamond Cutter can come at you from any number of angles.
But
the Diamond Dallas Page has a tremendous repertoire of other wrestling moves he can beat you with.
I don't think he's anybody else. I'll look him up real quick. Because he doesn't look familiar at all. Other than Sick Boy.
Like, sometimes guys have weird gimmicks, and you're like, oh, okay. You're like, Sick Boy was the first draft.
I do love the fact that Sick Boy, random wrestler Sick Boy, gets a shot at the U.S. title on a random episode of Thunder.
Oh, we got it. We got the super cool.
Yeah, there's no doubt about this Sick Boy. I don't know his name, but his first name is Sick, and his last name is Boy, Mr. Boy here. He's a big customer.
First name Sick, last name Boy.
Thank you, Frame. Exactly what I would be saying on commentary, so I love it.
So Sick Boy's first pro match ever was about a here with DDP.
Sick boy Dave, but sick boy going for a maneuver here. How about that? Hooked him by the shoulder. Wow, of course.
Yeah. So he's a WCW power plant guy.
He almost had a major upset.
I wasn't sure.
Bell,
like,
as he almost pinned the
Reese
US
was obviously the yes
day. He's arguing with Charles
yep.
giving Paige the opportunity to roll him up. And,
I'm wondering if Sick Boy was anybody else.
And he wrestled DDP for the US title later, and the wrestled Rick Steiner for the DDP title. Oh!
You just hit Sick Boy, flip on a banana peel.
And you get counted out real quick here.
Well, now you got both of these guys trying to struggle to their feet. DDP first to his feet. Big right hand, and Sick Boy's rock here.
Left hand to the side of the head, DDP. One thing that we've always known about him, he is a fighter.
Fun fact, I'll give you one fun fact. He was hired by WWE specifically to be in the Katie Vick storyline and was not ultimately used.
Wow.
So yeah.
Claim the fame.
Look him up on Wikipedia.
Good move. He stayed long enough. He
but one time he'd be glad you were
possible.
He was
hurt. He was just playing possible, Sick Boy.
Guys, we talked so much about DDP's injured ribs. Let's not forget it was that leg that was injured very recently as well. Sick Boy, very smart.
Nice.
Oh, that's over. Out of nowhere.
Diamond cutter. Good night. Spectacular.
That body drop into a diamond cutter.
Sick Boy's real name is Robert Vick.
Oh.
He was supposed to be the brother of Katie Vick. So this fictitious Katie Vick is named after a real person.
What?
Who is who's not in the program anyway. Anyway, back to Thunder.
Look at this look from Lodi. This guy looks like a member of the Prodigy.
It's like if like Bono went on a cocaine binge and ate.
He reminds me of he looks like he should be in that band Crazy Town.
Yes. Also, Southie said that Scotty Riggs was at ringside holding a sign that said "Riggs rules." Holding a sign for himself.
Champion, he goes in there and celebrates the victory.
And just like the Sandman, he disappears into the crowd.
Oh, and he set the belt down too. Well, that belt's gone.
Was that his act? That wasn't his. He had the Nirvana like cover, right?
Yeah, that was the WWE cover.
Oh, okay. That was the cover of the cover.
This was unexpected, but you can't.
Yeah,
because
he originally had Jimmy Hart "Smells Like Teen Spirit" rip off.
Right.
Yeah.
Mean.
Yeah. And Raven had the "Come As You Are" rip off.
Like a good neighbor.
Yep.
State Farm is there. We did it again.
Yeah.
Don't know why they didn't get to an even flow rip off for Raven.
And our customers rated us number one for network quality in America.
Because Chris Jericho had
that.
Just too late. Just too late.
You would think the guy who had a move named after it.
They just did the 3-2
countdown.
Yeah, they did the 3-2-1 cheer thing. That's funny.
Executive Committee JJ Dillon and James this past Monday on Nitro.
That's actually just WCW doing.
Spit in the face of authority by jackknifing Ray Traylor. I think we all expect a swift reaction from the WCW Executive Committee.
Mike, I think it would be an understatement to say that I was personally shocked and appalled by the blatant disregard for the rules and authority demonstrated by Kevin Nash Monday night.
I'm also shocked that he powerbombed Ray Traylor.
The jackknife powerbomb for good reason. And this is not a laughing, joking matter. We mean business. So Kevin Nash, as a result of your conduct, Monday night, following the ruling, WCW has levied a fine
while we're watching
against
a promo.
You of 50,000.
What are you, I don't know if it's me or someone else.
Holy smoke,
someone's mic sounds like a helicopter.
But this is the first and only time
like, I just keep hearing it in my ears. I just keep hearing like...
Do you hear anything right now?
Yeah. I just noticed it. during like the last, the end of the last segment.
Went away.
Do you still hear it?
Yeah, yeah, a little bit.
So it's me. Perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, there's like something. It's got like a like a pulsating sound.
Hmm.
Hold on
here.
I just didn't want to get all the way to the end and then you go to like look at it and be like, oh no.
Is it still there now?
It is.
Hmm, what the hell? How about now?
I heard it for a second and then went away. I can't
hear you. One second. Shit.
I hear it like very slightly in the background. Not as bad as it was before, but still a little bit.
There still is?
Yeah, it's lower, but it's still in the background.
I'm trying to figure out what the hell else it could be. Unless it's just interference, something's interfering, I don't know.
I don't hear it now.
Okay. Does this sound, everything sound cool though right now? Just let me know.
And maybe that'll wipe that smirk off your face. Now, I don't know who's paying this fine. You want to go back to the beginning of this like promo and we could just cut out any of that?
Yeah, we could do that.
I figured it just made... That was why I brought it up during this, because I knew we weren't saying anything anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sounds good. I love if he just gave that to someone. Like, it looks like a lady who was just there. Like, just someone.
Yeah, he's not getting that belt back.
Like, right, that would be like if you were there with your girlfriend. You look like you gave her the cut. What do I do with it?
She wouldn't know what to do with it.
W Executive Committee, J.J. Dillon. And it's James, like, this past Monday on Nitro, you announced the ban of the powerbomb. Yet Kevin Nash spit in the face of authority by jackknifing Ray Traylor. I think we all expect a swift reaction from the WCW Executive Committee.
Powerbomb is too dangerous.
Mike, I think it would be an understatement to say that I was personally shocked and appalled by the blatant disregard for the rules and authority demonstrated by Kevin Nash Monday night. WCW
banned. Wonder if he's holding a scroll that has a treasure map on it in his hands.
And this is not a laughing, joking matter.
It's the treasure map to find out who's going to become champion of the vacant belt that was still vacant yesterday, I'm pretty sure.
Dude, he has that thing rolled tight.
That's definitely like five scripts ago before it was changed by everyone in the back.
It's just text of a recap.
And maybe that'll wipe that smirk off your face. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't know who's
it says JJ promo
line,
on it, and nothing else.
I have my suspicions. And I would like to make the point that even people that run in Hollywood circles, if you get my drift, know that there are budgets to everything. I don't care if it's...
Yeah, we get your drift, JJ. It's not that
And
clever.
If enough of these fines
you
are
explained
levied,
it pretty
maybe
clearly.
We'll get some people's attention, because we do mean business.
Well, the voice of authority has spoken. Tony, Bobby, and Lee, $50,000 fine levied against
like,
Kevin Nash.
You get what I mean.
That's
yeah,
one of the biggest fines I've ever heard in the sport. And I think it's justified.
We're going to keep the title vacant, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Why not? And
it's like Give us the Beatles, but they're like, if you know what I mean. We yeah, you said exactly what you meant.
The verbiage is right there. He has spit in the face of authority.
Didn't need to care about it. We're a creep.
On WCW
Monday. Oh, here we go. We got Ming.
It didn't bother. Hopefully this will be the beginning of bothering him about that. That very dangerous.
You got the big Ming, and then you got the medium-sized Ming.
Who's Ming gonna murder tonight?
Everybody could read between the very thin lines of JJ.
Oh, it could be anybody.
Even those kind of people have
I don't like that he's coming out first.
We're taking bets?
You get hit with a couple I wish there was someone already in the ring for him to kill.
I hope it's Manga.
Oh, no.
Well, like you said, they spit in the face of authority. Kevin Nash did. I think he just wanted to test the water to see WCW my business.
Yep.
$50,000 to me.
Yep.
How's me doing in
business? Oh my god.
Oh no.
Yeah, yeah. He was out there every now and then.
This isn't over yet.
Late 90s.
This Thunder has potential to go to four just off of this match.
This is a battle of two guys who may not want to do business.
And that is Ming, and this should be a big time heavyweight bout.
Oh, Ming is taking a shot from that 2x4, no doubt. He's not gonna sell it.
It might be from himself. Like,
we're gonna have Booker T defend the TV title against Center.
This match could be anything.
Jericho and Eddie Guerrero together against
this match could be the highlight of everything we've seen so far.
This match could go.
Was he almost two stepping?
This match could go 2 minutes or 15 minutes.
It's gonna end during the commercial break.
That's what they got later on in the telecast. But right now, guys, Hexon
Jim
Duggan, Great American, man, one of the most feared men in our sport, Billy Silverman, the referee, and we are
nice.
Ready to go this week on Thunder.
Okay.
You're talking about the big heavy hitters you got in the ring right now, Duggan and Ming.
Also they already know that the moment of the week is coming from this match. They're setting it up now.
Duggan.
That's xenophobic. I appreciate it.
Duggan uses this as a force, uses this as momentum to get things going. He's way Duggan! Big double axe handle sledgehammer blows, sending Ming up against the corner. You know, we talk so much about the power of Ming, but Duggan, truly one of the most powerful men in our sport, guys.
All right, Ming playing ball. I'm kind of surprised.
The way he winds up and just punches you with it, but Ming, he's a guy that can take it.
Tuning up the band.
Already tuning up the band.
Being outside the ring there, he was motioning to the throat. He wants
to get this boot
as quick as he can.
I like the foot boots.
Into the ring post. On the outside, Duggan now getting an earful from Jimmy Hart. This is what Hart wants. He gets the
ball. Oh, geez.
Jimmy Hart puts over the head.
Oh.
What about this?
Hacksaw is the only wrestler, the only face wrestler who cheats when he has the advantage. And that happens way more often than it should.
That's one of the things that Hacksaw Jim Duggan does best, is hit you with those huge roundhouse rights.
Ming already
has a dozen of them.
But always,
Ming is like, get out of here with that
loose,
loose
bottom rope.
You gotta take your eyes off your opponent.
By the way, what is Jimmy Hart wearing?
A lot of times you'll be
looks like a bowling
crazy.
Duggan won right there. Duggan. Firing back, and he and Ming just slugging it out right now.
Jimmy gives me a Weird Al vibe here.
Jimmy Hart looks like he's wearing a shirt that is like made of like recycled copies of Siphon Filter on PS1. Bright green.
Reaching towards Jimmy Hart, Duggan needs to leave Hart alone and worry about the task at hand, and that is the big man Ming. Wrong road to take,
oh.
But that does not deter Duggan.
Ming might hit himself with a 2x4.
Ming, yeah, Ming's wrestling himself, too.
But he didn't slow down. Ming, reaching high for
the... Yo, check out this cameraman, looks like Arn Anderson on the outside. Lodi's
still out there just marking out.
Big time brawl going on here on Thunder.
Terrible strategy.
I would be too.
And that's why America is not as good as the Polynesian island.
Because
if Ming would have dove at, Ming hit himself in the head with a turnbuckle all the time.
Hacked off
once. Done. USA, zero. Tonga, one.
Keep him good American down.
Duggan firing three elbows and now a thundering right hand. He's out. He's up.
Wrestling needs more tongue and death grip.
Well, wrestling needs more Ming. Ming didn't even do a move there. That wasn't a double line. That was... That was Hacksaw hitting Ming with a line. Ming is so sturdy, but also not Hacksaw. Yeah.
Trying to get the ref's attention here.
Is that like spray-painted silver?
I don't know what's going on with that.
Yeah, or it's like, oh shit.
Ming, oh, it's gimmick, that's why. It's
friggin' corked 2x4.
It's probably just a prop.
The 2x4.
Yeah.
Fuck you, Hacksaw.
Doesn't sell the 2x4 and then grabs him by the chin for the finish.
This may be a match of two guys who do not exist.
What a cover.
He's dead. R.I.P. America.
His heart is no longer beating.
1776. 1998. It was a good run.
Somehow Jimmy Hart seems to be the most beat up out of everyone. A torture test?
Jimmy Hart threw the 2x4 right to Hacksaw.
Yeah.
I forgot he was managing Ming and not Hacksaw.
He was trying to turn on him, and it didn't work out.
But Ming, after multiple shots of the 2x4, said nah to him and just stood up. He did a bucket. He went down to his knees, and that was it. And he's like, you're 2x4, stupid. Incredible. I love Ming. I want Ming to wrestle 8 more times in this show.
Oh, if it was 10 years ago, Ming would be like the GCW champion.
Nobody becomes a stepdad by accident. You have to want it, which means heart, determination, and dedication to make that dad bod a father figure. But if you want to be the raddest dad on the block, all you have to do is head over to ProWrestlingTees.com/stepdads to get the official merch of the parental guardians of the galaxy, the stepdads. Do it for your old man and order now.
What the fudge?
Ming Sammy Callahan, maybe?
Ming Chris Dickinson.
Oh.
Welcome to the runway.
Ming versus Karrion Kross.
There we go.
Clone Ming and make Ming versus Ming.
Yeah, Ming versus Ming for sure.
We have the science.
Ming versus Haku.
I still think it's hilarious that this Saturday night intro lasted like a decade. It never changed.
We're gonna see Bill Goldberg against Ming. Scott Hudson and Mike Tenay will bring you all the action of WCW Saturday night.
Did he say Goldberg versus Ming?
On TBS. As we are live on Thunder at a capacity crowd, Raven is in the ring.
Like the best show of the week, every time.
Yeah. It really does.
Real oddball, isn't it? What they don't understand or what they can't comprehend.
Oh man, you don't match what I think need? This match will Ming be versus TCO.
Dude.
Oh, yes.
Nevermore.
Yes.
So Raven to face Marty Jannetty in the next bout. And as he said, anything
goes. Oh shit.
Jannetty's still here.
No disqualification. We have seen some wild brawls.
I'm shocked.
Jannetty's been drafted under contract for over a week. And who wrestled?
WCW Monday Nitro on TNT, where Raven won Raven's spot for attacking Chris Benoit. Benoit had a match with this man, Marty Jannetty. Jannetty turned things around.
The set is so good.
This is not good, Marty Jannetty.
Now Jannetty takes that. But the set is great.
Marty Jannetty coming out to intimidating music is really creepy.
He
belt, Jannetty was an interloper getting involved in the Flocks business. And for that reason, he wants Jannetty here on Thunder tonight. But like you said,
I'm really surprised how much they're like going Jannetty on TV. They must have really thought decent of him at this point. We saw him get sold out.
Yeah, this has to be like probably just before he plummets.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Like literally just before.
You wouldn't put the guy rocking this week here?
He took it off last week. I thought he was going to take it off again.
Maybe he'll take it off when he fires up tonight.
Though he wrestled who? What did he wrestle last week?
Martel, right?
So wasn't it Saturn?
Saturn, yes.
Oh shit, yeah.
So this is a continuation of being involved. With
right, yeah, team. Right, yeah.
Oh, you got to see that rings of Saturn.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Why?
That hurt.
Jannetty trying to keep the job.
Did he just turn you a helicopter?
He's just
regretting every
definitely just tore his pec right there.
Yeah, regretting that immediately.
So I'm looking up Marty Jannetty facts. Fun fact, he debuted in Mid-South Wrestling. So he literally debuted around the Mid-South Coliseum where he's wrestling right now.
Oh shit.
That almost took his eye out the chair, did.
That's when Scotty Riggs had two good eyes.
They still wear the eye patch as a result of what Raven did.
Scotty Riggs already has his messed up eye, huh?
He's
going
to need one.
How did they win Pace a messed up Riggs eye?
How he lost his eye?
Yeah.
But Raven rebounds from that. I don't remember.
All I remember about him is him having the eye patch. I don't remember him actually getting it, like, injured.
Raven up and Raven back down. Here's a cover.
I think he got injured while he was still an American Nail or right after.
Okay.
So it's that weird, like, middle ground.
Orthopedic boot on his right foot. Actually, he has one leg an inch and a half shorter than the other. We understand. So. One of the more bizarre features of this man who did you see him smile in the corner? He was hammered by Jannetty in the corner, and much like we saw against Benoit at Sold Out, he seems to enjoy the pain and seems to enjoy what something bad happens to him. A roll up one, two, and he got a two count on it.
And then he did not look like he was gonna get that leg up there. Raven looks dead. He's not even in position for this move. He just like inside.
Oh. Hammer fist is hair follicle.
I mean, if you're ever going to do it anywhere, you might as well do Jerry Lawler's second finisher in the Mid-South Coliseum.
Was that a big hair move? Or big, what the hell was that?
Big hair energy?
big fist move there.
Yeah, all the time.
Oh, there you go.
Into the matchup, I'm not sure. He's going to try, but don't maybe try to cover the man, but no, he's not.
So according to this, Jannetty sticks around until August.
Bam.
He might get some bangers out of nowhere here.
So who knows how much he'll be on TV. Oh my god, the most disrespectful fan of all time.
Oh, the cameraman's trying to get the crowd to wave their arms.
That was a very hard match for Raven as Raven stands up.
What about him? What about Raven?
We're heading to February 22nd to Super Brawl 8 and the biggest return match ever.
Here we go.
I was one.
They go to Jannetty, takes it right in the kidney area. Right in the short area.
He's like,
Raven drops it. I was once in a locker room with Raven. Where Raven was having a 30-minute conversation with Jushin Liger.
One, two, three.
And I couldn't get out of the locker room because they were standing in front of the exit, and I didn't want to ask either of them to move because I was a nobody.
Dude.
So I had a 30-minute conversation about Street Fighter with Kenny Omega. What a weird time.
Nice. Dude, I want to...
I was wearing a shirt of, it was like Super Mario, but he was like in the style of M. Bison. Like Street Fighter style.
Yeah.
He was throwing a Hadouken. And Raven was like, what is that? And I was like, oh, it's like a video game reference. And he was like, I'm in a comic. And I was just like, okay,
What was that, 2005, 2006?
No, like, body wash.
Out of the parkers.com, more renters get into new homes than any other site. It's really as simple as
taking. It was like, I think Jersey All-Pro was running their anniversary show. It was a two-day anniversary
the most popular place
in Philly and then Raleigh.
So look who we have here.
Jerry Lewis. Famous for...
Oh, he has no idea where he is.
Famous for writing Great Balls of Fire and marrying his teenage cousin.
Jerry Lee Lewis, Carl Perkins, Johnny Cash, and the killer Elvis Presley as well.
Here with his family, his killer.
He's like, did I just wrestle a match?
Jerry Lee Lewis.
Yeah, he definitely has no idea where he is.
Honorary member of the Fly.
We all remember Saturn,
Reed, Rick, Jerry.
Jerry became the new stick boy after today.
The stick boy got kicked out after he lost to DDT.
Here we go, Yuji Nagata.
Nagata.
He already looked confused. Always good to start when you...
I live for. You need a guy who's going against anyone here.
I'm going to get you with the cat. I'm going to go with the cat.
I'm hoping it's Nordic or Blake.
For Monday, March 2nd, Nitro returning to Philadelphia.
Goldberg.
Oh, you know, right? You know, right? You can die. Man, I told you, it could be anyone.
But that's what I love about WCW. Every match is a grab bag of whatever the hell's going on in the world. Not even in the company, in the whole friggin' world.
Because, like, there was a 50-50 chance that was going to be Bill Goldberg or Ray Trailer. Like, and I would have been not surprised.
What is Goldberg trying to get out of his head, do you think? When he hits himself like that.
He just, you know, he grew up just hearing all about how he was a failure, and his mom was like, you'll never be good enough to... And he's like, I'll show you, Mom.
Do you think this is a, take that, Mom and Dad, every time he spears the guy, right?
Yes. He just pictures... when Warner Boy pictures the guy making fun of his mama.
There you go.
So physically...
Like, he wins the world title, takes it to his dad. His dad doesn't even look at him over the newspaper.
Yeah,
doesn't matter. Not good enough, kid.
Very, very angry. Into the eyes goes Nagata. Goldberg, we have seen the jackhammer, but we have seen so much more. It's Goldberg. Look at that takedown. Lake submission hold.
Like, this could have legitimately been a Tokyo Dome main event in 2000.
Well, thus far, Yuji Nagata has hit Goldberg with about five offensive moves. Goldberg,
like, less than 2 years later.
Nagata quick to get to the ropes. This is going to be a good one.
Nagata smart. He'd be trying to find out where he left his passport and go home.
Nagata almost suckered him into getting close to him so he could hit him with repeated kicks. Now, about three of those did not faze him, but that one to the sternum did. And since Goldberg over, trying to pick him up.
Oh,
uh-oh, he's cool.
Freaking cross.
There we go.
Modified crossroads.
Spears him down. The fans erupt here. Goldberg is a man's man. And he sent Nagata down.
But this is how you get people over. Like, this is so simple and yet so effective. Forever. For the next 15 years in wrestling. This is how you do it.
It's all over. Again, Goldberg wins.
So sorry, Mr. Nagata.
Nagata was trying to take Goldberg vertical. Goldberg blocked it. Hit him with that spinning
neck. Oh, Sonny, get out of there.
On to begin academic. And Sonny Ono, he can't believe what he saw. He just got a light bulb.
Yeah, there's no way Sonny was taking a fall.
All the way back to Tokyo.
Goldberg decimates another one. Up next for Goldberg is Ming in the main event.
Goldberg hates cameras. That's another thing.
That should be legal as well, Brain.
Did you know that Goldberg is actually on the TV show The Goldberg?
Look at the power of this man. The power
yes.
of this man, Goldberg.
I haven't seen it, though, but yeah.
Is he Goldberg?
Like a gym teacher.
Right
yes, he plays a gym teacher, but he's not named Goldberg.
Oh.
He's going to still call the Goldberg, but he's not related to the Goldberg.
Mr. Goldberg, you the man. You the man.
He is the man.
Mr. Goldberg.
Right. You better call him Mr. Goldberg. That's exactly what it is.
Mr. Goldberg. Goldberg. I hope that's what he says next time he comes out.
If Vince Russo was here, he would definitely be Mr. Goldberg next week.
Bill Goldberg
yes.
for the burning questions in WCW. And there's a big question before the New World Order. How much more can this organization take before it literally falls apart? There's one man who's been the catalyst, the Macho Man Randy Savage.
I give it about 2 years.
Let me set the stage for you this past Monday on Nitro. We understood that the NWO arrived, different factions and different...
And he's going to beat him with that illegal move, the power bomb, too.
Miss Elizabeth was seen in Hollywood Hogan's limousine. Then
at least because
Gold Out
happened, we're not
going to
get the stupid, the giant can't touch neck storyline again.
Of the car.
Well, do you know what we have now? We have
the
giant is injured storyline.
Where Louis Spicoli, as a
at least he doesn't look like a wolf.
Scott Hall was wrestling Juventud Guerrero, and then the fireworks really started. Lee Marshall in the ring.
Oh, no kidding. As a matter of fact,
Scott Hall versus Juventud Guerrero.
So
what was happening?
He couldn't even figure out how to open the trunk on that.
We're missing all the good stuff.
He was about
stuff,
to rip the trunk open just to get his gear to run into the building, right?
Who would rent a car to
like
a man
like
that? This man
Saturday
is out
of night
the
night
deep end.
Here's what happened
when the NWO
it could have been on Worldwide or something random.
Hulk Hogan, big hold of the pecking order. Eric Bischoff.
Oh, Scott Hall there?
And the giant
Spicoli
there. Kevin Nash.
Wait, did Macho Man wrestle? Who be? Who wrestled Hoobie?
No,
I'm so
never.
Confused.
Cool heads need to
something.
Prevail, and my friend, yours is wound just a little too tight.
Well, that's really great. Glad you care about my loss to Luger. Glad you care about it. But guess what? I know you don't. Neither do you. Neither do you. And you make me sick.
Much.
Macho doing the classic. I hate you. I hate
it's
you. You're cool. You suck.
We're all here to fix it. And the man has got something he'd like to say to you.
Dying to hear it. You know, Madness, if you're part of the team, brother, you gotta realize you gotta play the whole game. Sometimes me and the big man, sometimes me and Scott, sometimes we have a difference of opinion. But we all love each other. K-Dog, Big Norton, Buff, the boss, Vince, we're all in this thing together.
He literally mentioned everyone except
the picture that we saw,
Mr. Well, yeah, no one gets
Macho Man, was it? You were winning no gold medals out there, and you
no
were exactly
what do you think,
dance
this?
With
Foxy. So just like, shut the hell up.
If you don't want us caring for you and meeting
you
want to
have an opinion, you go somewhere else.
All the way to victory, my man. You are on your own. And that's the way I want it. And believe me, you talk about a picture of confidence. You talk about a picture of control.
You talk about your psalms.
Better when he had the gold around his waist.
I just love listening to Macho Man talk.
I definitely get why Vince wanted him to be on commentary.
You
think it'd be main thing.
Two times, twice, brother.
Before when he said dying to hear it, I thought he was just about to tell Hogan to die. Die!
For the whole success of wrestling, and everybody knows I should have a belt around my waist right now. And just because
Vincent looks so bored.
Everybody knows. Yeah. In February,
he's falling asleep. He's literally falling asleep.
And Sting will be stopped.
Dude, imagine how much that guy just had to stand around in a ring while, like, a bunch of people were in the ring, and he's just thinking in his head, like, what the fuck am I doing tomorrow, you know?
Like he's getting paid to be a part of some of the most iconic moments in the 90s, and he's just standing
there.
He's
like, yeah.
He's the stormtrooper in the background during the war.
He's like that kid with the glasses and the curly hair who's in the background of every movie ever.
Yeah.
Or, you know, there's an extra who's in, like, every movie.
Yeah.
Maybe if that gets up in the corner, we'll talk more about that.
Yeah.
The Olympics and Paralympics are back, and watching our athletes will once again give the impression that America is the healthiest country
in
the
world. It's going to be interesting seeing how this leads to Kevin Nash forming the red and black, because that is not a thing right now.
Even though he's already wearing red and black.
Ever again. The health of our nation cannot just be measured by
right?
the victories of our champions. It
and
must
Macho
be
isn't.
Measured by the health of all of us.
I just appreciate that Conan wears some white theater with them to do. It's a good touch.
I hope it's not the same one every time.
But when he wrestled that show, he had just a regular one that didn't say it. That's his promo white theater.
But you never know if they're coming our way. That's why we made it a practice here at the broadcast location where we hear the NWO music to stand up.
That is still such a cool set.
It is.
Just when you think sometimes you got it down, they continue to surprise and shock. When they can't
wearing a thick shirt, a guy who's not in the company anymore. A guy who is directly feuding with them from another company.
Oh, not at this point. He hasn't debuted till March after
okay.
WrestleMania. So they might still think he's coming back, or they're just doing it to screw with people.
Exactly. Oh, they don't care. I mean, but you're right, it is before he comes in.
They have signed the Macho Man Randy Savage and Lex Luger at Super Brawl in a no disqualification match to add to Hollywood Hogan and Sting in the biggest rematch ever for the vacated world title. And I wonder if the fans, you're going to also raise a question, I'm sure, after what we've heard and what we've seen, how many members of the NWO will come to the Macho Man?
I'm confused at what the goal of the NWO is at this point.
And how much he'll want them to help
like,
out.
If they win the world title back, nothing really changes.
No, they're just... There's
never an endgame.
The storyline of the NWO at this point, in my mind, is that they have essentially taken over. They've gotten so big that it's just... guys let's fighting over who's actually in charge. And
like,
that's
like
behind the scenes, and also like
yeah.
in front of the camera.
Yeah, no, it makes sense if it's like if Raw and SmackDown were on the same show at the same time kind of thing, like a co-promote.
It's like when something grows to be too big and it can't sustain itself, that's the end of the world now.
What brings you out
in my mind.
House.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's how they view it, but it's how it looks retrospectively.
I bet you they didn't think about it at all.
Did all you people come to see WCW?
It's like, the NWO is the definition of that absolute power corrupts absolutely. Like, that's it.
Right.
They took over and now there's too many egos at the top. Both, like I said, both in the back and in front of the camera.
Did all you people come to see the...
It's the good kind of work shoot, but they weren't trying to work shoot it. Whereas if Russo was doing it at this point, he'd come
that's
in and be like,
close.
Shoot, brother. Like,
that's pretty close.
Right.
That's one more.
They're kind of doing one without being explicit about it.
Now, you probably saw the video earlier about Hogan and Sting and everybody crying about they want the belt.
No, we did not see that.
What happened to the thing about... the guy who won World War III, the big battle royal thing, that was me. So let me get this right.
Was that the first World War III?
Can come down was, in that? Dress
was that the first World War III that he won?
No, the first one was like 95. I think he won the last. Okay, right. He won the second one.
Okay. Because Nash wins one too, right?
He wins the last one, the third one.
Okay.
The Hulk won a title shot and still hasn't gotten it, and that was in November.
It's how many times you get up. And I'm coming after you.
Claim it. You're number one contender to a belt that is not held by anyone. Shouldn't that make you the champ?
That would have made a really cool twist if somebody who wasn't vying for power, like Hall, just is the champion now. And everyone makes everyone else mad.
Give the belt to the number one contender, and that's all.
Yeah. He won a 60-man battle world. Give him the belt.
But also would have been such a fun twist in the whole, like, yeah, it's like Hogan wants the belt. Yeah, these guys will take over the belt, and then the guy who's like the sidekick that is like wins it.
Only the next member. Yeah, no, I like that. That would have been cool. Just seeing Hall with the belt would have been cool anyway.
Why?
Honestly, it might be the worst NWO member out of everybody because Dusty is so ingrained in WCW and the NWA that it makes absolutely no sense.
Yeah, it's really stupid.
The only person that would have been worse is if Flair himself was me. It's the only worst.
Like, this is the guy who on commentary announced Hogan turn.
Yeah.
It's so, and like, it's iconic, and it's so silly to have him be part of it.
Why don't you lay a little rap?
Even just taking history out of it. Everybody here wants to hear
Dusty Rhodes testify.
Right. But don't worry, he's got that six shirt too.
Thank you, brother. Hey, is this just.
I think they just gave out six shirts to everybody in the back because he's gone. So they're not selling his merch anymore, so they might as well just give it to the boys.
They probably sold out of regular NWO shirts.
One time, so you better pull up and listen to it, cause we ain't gonna talk about it again. In 1991, corporate America tried to tear down what I had helped build. They tried to tear down tradition of wrestling.
So now I'm gonna join the group that's going against.
I wore the suit and tie. I talked with the suits every day. I said, yes sir, no sir, yes sir, no sir. And now you know what? You can take them suits and shove it, baby.
But that was 7 years ago.
They moved me down. They moved me down to do some color commentating, and after carrying
that is not all doing his pose even in the dark with no spotlight on him.
Yep.
I got so sick and tired of it. I got pain tired of it.
This is so nonsensical.
Easy E.
Tony Schiavone's gonna fight Dusty.
A man of vision.
It's just
a man of one hell of a vision.
He's talking about something that involves no one who's involved in the company at the moment.
The sounding board for wrestling as we know it.
Also, Dusty's whole gimmick is to be the son of a plumber, the hard-working man, the blue-collar guy. And for him to just be like, I'm tired of working hard. It's so stupid. Am I wrong? Like, it's so, it's like,
I think he's trying to say that it's like he's fighting corporate America, which is a blue-collar thing, but the NWO is like also corporate in its own way.
Yeah. Now, dear, he's still selling out.
Let me tell you one other thing here before you start that music.
Oh, they tried to send him out.
Why don't somebody go down
it's like they're trying to act like Dusty is fighting the power like Stone Cold is against Vince. But like,
right. And that doesn't make any sense.
And Larry Zbysko, let me tell you something.
No, because actually he joined it.
There will be no comeback.
And like, in the storyline, he used to help run WCW.
Yeah.
And can you imagine? Not least, JJ,
would, like, don't you ever I'm tired of fighting stuff. Come on, Mr. McMahon, give me a hug.
No, this is the equivalent of if Vince turned face on, like, Shane because screw corporate America. That's what this is.
Last but not least, my man Kevin Nash.
Vince joined DX.
Yeah, that's literally the equivalent.
And I can't get in the ring and defend myself.
He's like, I'm tired of fighting all these guys who are trying to overthrow my company, so I'm just going to join them. Vince McMahon just coming out and saying to suck it to everybody. Like,
and for my man Six Pack, you're just too sweet, baby. Just too sweet. So without further ado,
and like I said, of all the people to do it with, it makes the least sense of Dundee. Because his whole character is based on being this blue collar, hard worker, never give up kind of guy. So for him to sell out first, like earlier than most, makes no sense.
Yeah, I'm fine.
I don't see how long he was in the NWO.
It had to be like a couple months. Like, I don't think it was long. I think even he was like, this is stupid.
This absolutely feels like they had him turn, and then they just said, well, you come up with why it happened. And that's probably the best thing you can do, really.
Yeah.
I feel like that's NWO in a nutshell. It's like, people are like, I want to join the NWO. It's like, okay, join and we'll figure it out later.
You might not expect a talking dog, but you can't expect State Farm to be there no matter what happens next. It's called service.
I can't believe you could talk. High five.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Verizon launched the first 5G network, and now we want to be the first to give everyone the joy of 5G by giving every customer a new 5G phone. Old customers, new customers, new 5G phones.
So apparently Dusty turned at sold out, and Tony Schiavone was so messed up by it that he left the announcer's desk and came back like a while later. He was so mad, which is cool. Good touch.
That's a good touch. Stupid storyline, but great touch.
Dusty's in the NWO until November, and he does have an angle where he defects back to WCW.
Good. It makes no sense for him to be there. Here comes Disco. White people gonna white people.
Oh, look at this. Look at this headband. I still stand by Disco could have been a really good wrestler.
He talks about tradition and what he's done.
I think there's glimmers of really excellent wrestling, especially in
1990.
Dude, right? I was like, oh, wait, who is he going against? And I was like, oh, shit, they're already Dusty in the hall.
Oh, got it, the Giant.
Oh, he's going to mock the Giant.
That's right, he's on first with a choke slam and now mocking the Giant.
I love
Scott
Hall.
Oh, look at this.
He's like one of the few people who gets that, like, the NWO angle is not about themselves, but, like, the people they're against.
We might be the only one that knows that. I wish he was the leader, I really do.
Because, like, Nash would have just done the choke slam and then, like, not reference the Giant at all. But, like, the fact that he, like, played up the whole thing of, like, the thing last night with the pay-per-view.
Stunners.
What's the his stunner called?
The tart chop. The chart topper.
The chart topper. That's
yeah.
It.
Look at Scott. He even teased that he loses to Disco Inferno. That's how much he doesn't care about the wins and losses.
No, because he gets the angle.
Now Scott Hall, he tries to.
He gets the idea that WCW has to look like a threat for once, maybe? Maybe?
Like, Nash and Hogan only, like, reference each other and the other members of the NWO. And, like, the WCW does it. Paul is just like one guy who keeps them grounded to the company.
Yeah.
The thing that impressed me the most was first Disco got onto the outsider's edge, and then in doing so put the chart.
That's something I never noticed when we were watching this, but like,
You know, I don't know how hard to get it than need be, but the fact that, yeah,
it's almost like
rules, you see the
there's two NWOs, because it's Paul feuding with WCW still, and then all the guys with the big egos feuding with each other, but it doesn't really matter, because now I guess the WCW guys.
I like the one guy who's like, it's like when you have two groups of friends, and like you try to balance your time between the two, and Paul actually gets it.
And certainly takes his own sweet time trying to make a cover.
Like you said, Brain, there's three times the heavyweight champion of the world. You look up and down the roster,
like the nerdy kid who also plays
world champions, former champions. You can't tell me that Scott Hall isn't at least a little resentful about missing his opportunity.
What, oh, sure. Outsider edge. Outsider edge.
Just got up at once.
Dead. Good take. I love when people don't just flat bump the razors. I like it. Roll it. It looks so much better.
Yeah. I agree. Sell it like you just got hit by a car, you know? Bounce around a little bit. Ragdoll.
Yeah, it's more like, there's more momentum to it. Rather than just like, we're falling into a flat back bump.
Right. You can't just rely on the camera to show the impact. Your body has to really show the impact.
Yeah. It's a weird that I'd be complimenting Disco, but here we are.
There you have it, the man who's been the number one contender since November, and here we are in February.
And he's fighting Disco Inferno in a throwaway match that he almost won.
Would Disco become the number one contender? Number two contender?
No, they just fire him.
The help of Dusty Rose.
They just act like it didn't happen.
Program, Booker T will defend the TV belt. Kevin Nash and Kone will defend the World Tag Team belts against the Steiner Brothers.
Paul was probably the only guy who remembered he was number one contender and just like brought it up, and they were like, oh, you should mention that. That's a great. We totally forgot.
I don't know if you heard, but the team of Kevin Nash and Conan are defending the tag team titles.
Oh, my favorite tag team, yeah.
You know, not Scott Hall, the guy we just saw who could have easily been in that tag team match instead.
But dear stranger, it's always you riding with me. To help me back on my feet and my work.
Huh. Welcome back to Thunder, Memphis, Tennessee. Here is the man who was the center of controversy at Starrcade when he officiated the Hollywood Hogan Sting World's title match and was accused of a quick count.
About
suspended referee Nick Patrick. And Mr. Patrick, I understand that you have a statement to make.
Yes, I do. It's been
time
a little
moves
over a month
w-
now since I've
w
been
World.
Suspended without pay because of the controversial call.
I didn't know Austin Powers was the ref
I've got
WCW.
A question for everyone out here.
Yeah,
everyone
I
who watches
he
any
came
sports,
out here,
have you ever seen
like,
two officials that officiated
exactly
the same
like
way?
Ref, it's like,
same
I've been
style,
suspended.
Same movement,
I'm
the same
on the three.
You can watch tonight's matches.
Or Kenny Powers.
We have our own style. Our
Kenny,
own
Powers.
He does look like Kenny Powers.
Now, let me flash you back in time to the controversy, the match between Hogan and Sting. It was more of a brawl, actually.
Let me flash you back in time.
All of you that have had a chance to see this on film now, think back.
Dude, he kind of sounds like him, too.
One attempt at a pinfall. Yeah. And when I went down and I slid, I made
the
count with my cadence.
The great
Bret Hart. He used to be a fucking wrestler.
He jumps in the ring.
He and his dad used to be wrestlers in the South.
Every time he gets ref bumped,
he
takes it like he got shot.
WCW stood by his decision. Not only did they do that, they suspended me.
Oh, legendary.
That's an outrage
legendary
to me. It should be an outrage to you people at home. It should be an outrage to all you people out here.
There should be gifts of dozens of Nick Patrick bumps.
The belt that says you are number one, the number one man in this sport. That's what they've done in one move by suspending me. They're not backing me
I love that
this.
Even WCW, they're well, like, we have to have the referee come out and put over the belt.
I can safely say that
to make sure it's
soon
that
you will
important.
Be seeing Nick Patrick again out here on these WCW programs. I think it's safe to say you will be seeing me again. And one more thing I'd like to say. I stand by my reputation. I stand by my decision, and I stand by my count till my dying day.
That's
and I understand that Sting and Hogan has a rematch signed, I want to be the man.
I mean, he might as well be a wrestler again.
I'm putting my name in the hat right now.
He has a decent promo.
That I'm not for life. I'm for real. Wow, Tony, do you believe that? Nick Patrick has thrown his hat into the ring. He wants to officiate the Hogan Sting return bout. Tony, back to you.
Well, I can believe that he wants
this
to
must be why I used to get mad in WWE when ball. They never talked about the referees and stuff. Because I grew up where not only were the referees named, but they had angles.
That's not a good thing.
I'm not saying it is.
And then WWE's answer to referee angles was having a ref trying to kill himself on digital every week.
Yeah.
And that sounds like I'm joking or saying he's just taking crazy bumps. No. He was trying to commit suicide every week on WWE.com.
Yep. Yep.
I mean, he's on the take. It's been pretty well documented.
I'm sure the videos are still out there somewhere. They did a lot of them.
Say here, but the fact of the matter is that the choice of the referee.
Oh, I forgot Saturn had hair.
I only remember because we saw him last week.
WCW, James J. Dillon, Monty Ronnie Piper.
I don't know why I forgot, but that was like a reveal to me.
And that's my opinion. Now,
if he can get reinstated,
here we go. This should be an awesome match.
Yo.
This,
okay. This is the first perfect Heat fighting on Thunder.
Yeah. Still got the Harlem Heat gear.
We talked about Philadelphia, a major announcement about our fans and WCW wrestling in Philadelphia.
I could argue that this is Booker T and Saturn's prime right here. 98 into 99.
Pre-Dreadlock, Booker T is my favorite Booker T. No, there's something I love about WCW Booker T.
Yeah, whenever he has that thing on his nose, the breather thing, that's the best Booker T.
For WCW Wrestling coming to Pittsburgh at the AJ Palumbo Center. That'll be Friday, March 6th. Tickets on sale tomorrow at the box office and all usual ticket outlets. And we'll be coming to Lincoln, Nebraska at Pershing Auditorium Friday, February 27th.
I don't like the cut
tickets
of this year, though.
Lincoln,
I don't
Nebraska,
get the weird,
and
like, diamond.
Coming in the course of Thunder here tonight about where you can get tickets for WCW coming your way. Right now, Saturn, who is now the number one contender for the TV belt, will go against the champion here, Booker T, in a return bout. And I say,
how did Saturn become the number one contender for the TV title?
Because
they said it like he won it.
Because he beat
into the number one contendership. He has the shot.
Whoever the hell he beat.
We saw what Saturn did just a short time back when he threw Rick Martel through that.
Did he beat Martel?
He beat Mario Jannetty.
No. Jannetty, yeah.
Once you beat Mario Jannetty, you go straight to the top.
Mario Jannetty would send me to Mario Jannetty with a number one contender.
Just one big, big tough man. And I'm a former world television champion himself.
Nothing says you're an anarchist quite like walking around at ringside with a sign that says anarchy on it.
Anarchy.
Fight the power on TBS, the superstation.
By Saturn, and Booker T is going to roll on the outside, and that may not be a safe place to be when you think about Raven Slot and over the top and colliding.
I wonder if you could get away with that anarchy sign at ringside today. Oh, whoa.
He ends up in Raven Slot.
I'm sure somebody would have a problem with somebody holding the anarchy sign.
Yeah, but in the 90s, it was all that one. Grunge and anarchy. Oh, yeah.
You know, excitement. Step to a slip jam. Oh, yeah.
The Dove Beauty Bar makes my skin feel fresh. I've encouraged Serena, my best friend, to switch. It was moisturized and cleaned by friend Stephanie. Her skin was dry. I'm like, girl, you better get you some Dove.
She hooked me up.
With the Porto Moisturizing Cream, Dove cleans effectively and cares beautifully.
Let's
leave them alone.
Okay, no, but I'm not done telling these people why they're wrong and stupid.
We just
got
a nice clean
kill. I'm sorry, I'm dirty.
The problem is not Big River, it's the road.
Let's do a secret catch. Whatever you do is right. Whenever you stop, it's done.
Lucky Brewster is back.
Holy mackinoli.
Go!
Always.
The action continues live.
And we're back.
Oh, he has a new sign.
Kidman, the real luchador. Oh my God.
That time almost straight down. Covering.
Booker T almost just landed on his head. That was like a Bret Hart style running belly to belly.
And that will turn raw power right around. That's what that will do.
See, everyone talks about the luchadors being really great, but WCW's like lower card was just as action packed. People forget
the mid card, US title, TV title, and the cruiserweights. Where were that?
Kick into the midsection, gut shot, the scissor kick in the back of the head.
Yeah, the undercard of WCW was so much more entertaining than the undercard of WWF. And not that WWF had good wrestlers, but all the matches were like 4 minutes, 5 minutes. Like, there was no. They didn't get a chance. But like, the wrestlers were good. The Godfather was good. D'Lo Brown was good. Val Venus was entertaining enough. Like, they had good guys. They just. All the matches were like 4 minutes. What a sell by Gilbert! They hit him with like dead fish shell off the apron.
Oh, and now he nailed
Jesus, Matt Damore.
He was hit from behind.
Wow, Martel does not leave that apron. I've never seen a guy get hit so many times on the apron and not fall.
Booker T thought for some time he had a debt of gratitude he was going to pay off to Rick Martel.
I'll also say, since we only have a second here with the TV belt, I absolutely love that TV title design. As a great, very simple and a great title design.
It's a good-looking belt. Took him right to the
limit. Little discrepancy, a little problem between Martel and Booker T, but Booker T is still the television champ. Don't forget, Rick Martel is still out there running a return shot earlier in the program.
So now who's the number one contender for the TV title? We got to look at the rankings, I guess.
Well, Raven beat Jannetty, so probably Raven.
That makes sense.
That's how you become the normal defender. You beat Marty Jannetty. You don't have to win a normal defender. You just, if you beat Marty Jannetty, you're the new normal defender.
So we can assume Sick Boy beat Marty Jannetty at a house show, and that's how he got shot at DDP.
Oh, Randy Savage,
yes.
He's like one of the flying. Well, London.
We'll test my theory and see if next week Raven gets a title shot.
I don't want anything from the New World Order. Well, be careful what you ask for, because you might just get it.
And that's what he got, Brain. And as a matter of fact, we're going to show the fans, I've never seen this before.
Thank you for that insight,
NWO,
Lee.
They didn't help themselves out.
Well, Savage doesn't
have
really
looking confident as ever.
A loose cannon. He's the most dangerous wrestler probably in the ring today.
You
can't control
cannon.
Him. You can't do business with him. You can't rationalize with him. The man should be institutionalized.
You heard what happened earlier in Nitro on Monday in our three-hour telecast. Now it was Lex Luger and Scott Hall. They were in the ring one-on-one, and the Macho Man got involved.
I smell replay.
Here in just a minute. But don't forget, as we said, the Macho
Man. But it's got Luger and Scott Hall in it. It'll be fine.
One-on-one in a no disqualification match against the Total Package Lex Luger. Now, is the NWO falling apart? Is this another chapter? We're going to take a look at the footage right now and show it to you.
Spoilers. The NWO lives forever.
Oh, it's like WrestleMania 7. He's going to do a billion elbow drops.
Crazy man. That was the most dangerous wrestler right there. I'll tell you who can stop
it. Now people are always like, remember when wrestling was real and Macho Man just climbed to the top?
Oh, is he
going to
kick him?
Oh!
That was awesome.
The flying... I don't know what. I thought he was about to German him.
You never splash somebody when they're not in the corner? That's what happens.
From behind when they're bent over? No. That's a felony. Without their consent? Absolutely not.
This thing went for the running Vader on him. So apparently Lex Luger won that match, I guess.
Sure.
We didn't see that part.
We're discovering how 5G can change their lives.
Let's not get Lex Luger over or anything, so let's not show the picture.
0-0 booking. By helping nobody get into over. New and that's just an accident.
We already knew all about the power of 5G. We've had it in every town and city for years. And also 6G.
I just want things to be in this too. Macho Man better turn around for this jacket. I'm just going to jump on him.
Apartments.com, the most popular place to find a place. Hello?
Oh boy, that is not Chris Jericho's actual theme.
Yeah, totally.
Oh. I like that they were trying to be clever putting it halfway through, though.
The best is they actually have
playing live.
Yeah, they have it playing with like a it's like stadium, like Pro Tool.
Yeah, this is the mm-hmm.
Oh, also, Jericho is now the Cruiserweight Champion. Everybody.
They must have beaten Ray in their match.
Yeah. Was that on Saturday night? I don't remember when that was supposed to be.
I think it was sold out.
Was that sold out? Okay.
Yeah, this is my favorite WCW knockoff team. This is such a good Pearl Jam song.
Oh boy.
Who is this?
Is this Benoit?
Dude, this is Benoit. Oh my god.
Yeah, this is his actual WCW theme, yeah.
I would you could have given me 1,000 guesses and I would not have guessed.
I remember it.
Benoit music was like some 90s like New Jack Swing shit. Whatever that
I blew my own mind that I remembered it. I don't know what's worse, that Benoit came out to it or that Malenko came out to that weird bopping sound.
Like that feels like it feels like Benoit's team and Eddie's team get swapped. Because Eddie has that, like, super intense theme.
Yeah.
And Benoit has this, like, bopping ass nonsense.
Nah, Benoit should have had that, like, mysterious Rey Mysterio, like, dun-dun-dun-dun thing.
Yes. Yes. 100%.
Hogan and Sting will get it on. The title this time vacated.
That's what I was thinking of. The Rey Mysterio, like, killer music.
Well, you know.
I didn't say it because of that. Like, that's what it sounds like.
Ooh.
Right, yeah. Just the dramatic
like horror movie. Yeah.
Yeah. Jericho is on fire at this point.
And
just imagine. Right, no, I know, I'm just joking with you. Remember the first week of Jericho and how he was like, he had a little bit of charisma, and now he's like the actual Jericho we remember in like a 3 weeks' time.
Okay, I don't think he cares anymore. Well, this is like he's already at the point of like, I'm just going to do what I do. Like, this is Jericho, like, I'm not going to ask for permission. I'm going to do what I want and ask for permission.
And it's working for him. He's in the storylines and everything.
Yeah.
Also, this is a hell of a match, too.
Yeah.
These two men have gone round and
round. If we throw out one guy, it's the Radical.
One of the things that yeah, that's these true. Greater, what a stacked mid card. My God.
And all four of these men have
so many counter moves, so many ways to win and escape
within the next couple of years.
There's a back elbow that caught Malenko, but Malenko.
Like, think about that.
Malenko coming in 1-2. Malenko guys actually lured him into that power slam by holding his hand on his mouth.
Well, that was slick. That was beautiful. What a move.
And the fans erupt as Benoit comes in against Jericho.
The crybaby.
Oh, that is aptly put. Crybaby is right.
Chris Benoit, the wrestler, is legitimately one of my all-time favorites.
Has he got a headache?
Oh, what a sell.
I remember the little battle they had a week ago.
Oh yeah, as a kid I thought Benoit was awesome Benoit, as a wrestler. The intensity was so neat.
Obviously, can't condone what he did as a human, but in the ring, the guy was incredible.
Now you're hitting
hip region to soften you up for it. But Jericho with a great counterbow. Look how long he holds him up with a vertical suplex.
Right, that's another good thing, that Jericho, being in the Cruiserweight division, got to do a lot of power moves, so.
Yeah.
Wasted some time as well, calling out to the fans.
Okay, weirdly, Benoit changed the industry for the better, or however you look at it, in the long run. Let's headshot.
Legendary Stu Hart, father of Bret the
It's important. It's like, it's an important thing. It's a shame the way it had to happen, but...
The greatest wrestlers in the world, some of them have come from Calgary, and you're seeing them right now, holding on to the ropes. Benoit into the midsection. Jericho will not let go. So Benoit's going to try to pound him down. So what's best? Hold in the corner, get pounded, or get whipped into the other side? I frankly don't know. You're about
ready to see a shame. I'm going to figure out how this angle works, because... right now, Jericho's a Cruiserweight champion, but I'm pretty sure no one else is a Cruiserweight, technically, in the
Well,
Jericho's just kind of randomly, maybe Eddie, but he's on Eddie's side, so he's not wrestling.
To me, when I saw Eddie coming out with Jericho, it felt like they were trying to do like a keep your enemy closer type thing with the two of them.
So many great wrestlers come through our...
Okay.
Our Nitro and Thunder telecast in WCW Center.
Because Jericho did cost Eddie his title shot at the last Thunder because he attacked Mysterio.
One, two, but we've seen wrestling with different concentrations.
So Eddie's going to feel like he should get a shot at Jericho because
Chris Benoit has the greatest concentration of anyone.
He kind of costed his shot against Ray and then Jericho beat Ray.
On Chris Jericho's part here, guys.
Well, you talk about concentration. The guy standing on the apron there concentrates. Probably as good as anybody. I'm talking about Dean Malenko.
It's crazy to think that they ended up having Cruiserweight tag team titles, because this could have easily been the Cruiserweight tag team division in 98. And that would have been unbelievable. I mean, it still is, but they could have had a lot more of these tag matches. And everything's solid. Oh.
He's got
everything's
him.
Awesome.
That's what he does. One, he's got two, and Malenko seeing the same thing, Brain, comes in for the save.
He had him. Malenko hadn't made that save.
Oh, look at this great team.
Especially if you think what's on the other channel right now, it's like the Road Warriors and the new Rock and Roll, or the new Midnight Express. Like, it's not anything like this.
I want to point out how much I love Benoit dragging Eddie to the corner, and like dragging him so fast, like he fell down into the corner because he had all his weight pulling him to stop him from making his tag.
Mm-hmm.
Little things I love.
And a forearm shot into that Texas clover leaf.
It's interesting because in wrestling, everyone tells you to slow down. He's able to stay really intense and fast while still being slow enough, like a pro would be. It's a weird balance.
These four guys are the definition of guys who could do stuff fast, but do it so well that you still see every single little thing they're doing, where it still works because.
The execution is fast, but the transitions are still like slower pace.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's not that they have time to sell.
Yeah, you don't miss the third state essentially every detail.
Back up top.
Oh boy.
This is incredible.
All we can say at this point
he went and shot him in the face.
But they just did a whole long sequence, and then they waited to do their spot until the crowd was ready to watch them. But there was no overlap, but it wasn't drawn out either. Flying nothing to ready.
That was an awesome finish.
That was a cool finish.
And Jericho immediately tapped out again. I really like that was his strategy at this time, was to immediately tap out of submissions.
Self-preservation.
Yeah, I wish every wrestler did that.
Yeah, it's very,
at least the heel.
It's very lose the battle, win the war mentality.
Yeah. And fun fact, about a year from now, Benoit Malenko will be the WCW Tag Champions.
Suplex him off that top rope to the middle of the ring.
There's a little continuity for you.
Benoit dives off that top rope, nails Jericho. Guerrero comes off that other top rope. He gets nailed with the double feet from Dean Malenko. And he taps out.
The double foot move.
There's a team, gentlemen. There is one heck of a team.
He went for the big nothing and got double foot.
For the flying nothing. Don't ever go for the flying nothing.
Thank you, Tony. Another impressive win for the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit, this time in a tag team match with Dean Malenko. And Chris, you certainly have to be satisfied with the recent series of victories over Raven's
Flock. Wait, he tell Dean to leave so that he can have his own promo? What's going on?
The recent sold-out pay-per-view.
Dean didn't get the pin for the submission?
No more.
Legendary mullet.
Chapter has come.
I love this hair. Oh, man.
You know, Chris, I've been on record
I'm really jealous
that
you are
the most accomplished wrestler to never have received a major title shot here in World Championship
Wrestling.
First of all, Mike, I don't need no belt of gold around my waist when I walk out here to prove to the world who I am and how good I am. All I need is an opponent, and for you out there to turn your TVs on and tune in. But Mike, because of my political incorrectness here and my affiliations, I don't get all the opportunities. But
yeah, he doesn't get opportunities like Sick Boy does.
Inflicting pain and punishment and crippling all opponents until someone takes notice.
Ladies until he beats Marty Jannetty.
I actually do love that.
Back over here.
Yo, it's like that mentality on the DDP.
That's DDP.
Somebody's taking notice.
No, it's a great mentality because there's like 200 wrestlers in WCW. You're not always going for titles.
And it fits out.
It takes time.
Like, it feels real for him. It's just like, I'm just going to keep hurting guys until someone gives me a shot. I don't need gold to prove I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
It's because the song.
And it means more when they get the title shot too, because they might get one every 5 years or something like that.
But you know what? They never saw me as the main eventer either. They were wrong about me, and I think they were wrong about you.
I
love that U.S. title.
I'll tell you why I feel that.
Okay, this is the big title of the company, right?
Yep.
I see how bad you want it.
It's the top title in the company,
yeah.
You got
the same look in your eyes when I look at myself, because I want it. The only problem is what you really, really want, I've got. So.
I love that belt design. I can't get over how great it is.
I want you to hear this. Because I want your reaction. Because since the promoters won't make the match, I'm going to see how the people react.
This is very real. I like it.
I want to know this. Is there anybody out there that wants to see Chris Benoit and DDP get it on?
See that? I vote yeah.
This feels like Bischoff is literally in the back, like, no one wants to see that. And DDP is like, yeah, bet. Like, it wouldn't surprise me the way WWE was run if that's how this happened.
Hey!
Chris?
You name the time. You name the place. You want to give me a shot? I'll take it. The place is Beaumont, Texas, and it's next Thursday on Thunder!
Oh, shit!
We have our main event, guys.
Episode 5, tune in. We're getting DDP versus Chris Benoit.
He accepts Silent but Violent 1 week from tonight. It's
Silent
the
but Violent.
State, the Diamond Cutter versus the Crippler Crossface. Tony, back to you.
Mike, I tell you, it's going to be 1 week they've agreed to it. Chris Benoit will get his long-awaited title shot, and we can't wait for Diamond Dallas Page and Chris Benoit. And we'll have our main event this week on Thunder when we come back.
Oh, shit. main event. Wait, the main event is NWO Nash, or what was the main event?
I'm not sure if that's tonight's main event or Nitro's main event, but I heard them say it was a world tag title match.
Yeah, literally, who knows?
Yeah, it could be Ming again.
We could get to next week and DDP versus Benoit doesn't even happen because they forgot about it.
That's true.
Yeah.
Tell your doctor about any fever, chills, or other signs of infection. Fresenio may cause the white blood cell counts, which can cause serious infection that can lead to death. Life-threatening lung inflammation can occur. Tell your doctor about any new or worsening trouble breathing, cough, or chest pain. Serious liver problems can happen. Symptoms include fatigue, appetite loss, stomach pain, and bleeding. No, I really like that last promo. That's, again, how you do a work, like, in a way that doesn't feel patronizing. Chest pain and rapid breathing
or heart rate, or if you are nursing... It was also a really good face-versus-face promo that didn't come off as corny at all.
No, just felt like a mutual respect, two hardworking guys.
You know, I'm going to look online exactly who are the WCW Tag Team Champions, because I'm pretty sure it's Paul and Nash, and I don't know why they didn't just team up.
You don't think it's 6-6 here?
Anything's possible with the NWO.
Is their tag team name 12?
Yeah. Definitively, yes.
It is now. I'm really surprised they didn't show the powerbomb that Kevin Nash gave. It's the gross one on his neck, and I'm really surprised they didn't show the footage.
This is actually Lowe's Outsiders.
Big sexy, the giant killer. When you're that size, we'll call
whatever you want.
Yes, I will.
Yeah, technically Nash and Hall are the champions right now.
Yeah, but the NWO does what they want. They don't. Here we go. Featured on Brooklyn Championship. They just don't care.
And it's exclusively here on Thunder Live here on TBS. Scott Steiner pointing. What's he pointing at? There's the dog-faced gremlin Rick Steiner.
Is Scott going to join
the
here?
The toughest man the sport's ever seen. And Scott, I can't spoil it for you. Ready with Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash fined $50,000 in arrested last week for his jackknife
powerbomb, the same one that took the giant down. Well, Buff's not there, so probably not. Rey Mysterio's on the shelf, right? He's going in for surgery. We know what's wrong with his knee. But there's been nothing said about it. Oh, apparently Rey Mysterio's in there.
Wait, yeah, right? Like, just think of, like, what if he is, like, complete randomness has to happen in order for that to happen. Because, like, what are they turning on right now? It's going to be Rick Steiner to start things. Is that a first? It's not even the tag team champions, so it's like... A few months ago, it wasn't unusual to see Rick start a
match. But DiBiase, he's made a decision he's going to start Rick Steiner. Also, very disappointed Conan took off the... his shirt for an actual proper NWO shirt. Represents Todos Latinos. Yeah. Says he represents all the Latinos from all over the world. Doubles Cubanos, little Mexicanos,
nah. Don't buy it. And the corner, double leg pickup, and Rich Dunn. Did he have his NWO shirt tucked into his underwear? And Conan,
just covering up in the corner. Well, you don't want to lose it. You're right, Tony.
Just pummel him. If you need more food at the NWO, is not what Rick Steiner likes to do. Let's not forget.
How about this? Oh, look at this STFU.
Into his underwear. Rich bone across the face. Whoa, come on.
Referee checking to make sure it's not a choke. It isn't.
This is not a case of me not understanding the 90s. I lived in the 90s. Pushes the head down, though. As Rick Steiner, stuffing your shirt into your underwear is definitively not cool then. Yeah. Belly to back. And a great move. And now Kevin Nash comes in. And that's going to be a strata punch. Scott and Rick both.
The big man down. That's the first time I've seen them work as a team for about, what, 3-4 weeks now.
Really, I'm shocked that Nash is already bumped in this match. Rick Steiner, Scott
Steiner. So yeah, then they're like putting over the fact that they're looking like a team right now. So like, Scott's obviously probably gonna turn on him.
Eventually, if not now, but eventually.
Now
Well, maybe if Scott teamed up with, you know, Nash as an actual team. Nash and Hall, I mean.
Isn't this the year that Rick breaks his neck, right?
Did Rick break his neck?
Oh no, he broke Buff's neck.
Don't spoil it. It's coming.
I'm confused again.
I thought it was the first episode, but yeah.
The longer Scott Steiner stays in there and jogs with the referee, the more beating his brother takes. His best bet's to get out in the apron and stay there.
Yeah, he's a very passionate, very intense individual, Scott Steiner.
Right now, the laziest tag of all time.
Nash, 7 feet tall, hammering the back of
Rick Steiner. Looks like he'd rather be doing anything else.
And knee right into the lower rib cage.
Oh, if he could, he would have Conan and Macho defend the tag titles for him and Hall.
Yeah.
$50,000.
At this point,
later.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's what that smirk off his face, didn't it?
Remember, I don't even know why they have tag titles. It does not matter.
Like, I love it. Like, a lot.
I don't think he thought it was
going to
be $50,000.
He's so, like, this era of Nash is, like,
so good,
like, all the time.
Snap hair down. That time by Conan. Conan, a
like, oh, I can't come lose the title. I set my toe. Like, that's the era.
And of course Scott has had enough.
And it's a shame.
There's the intense Scott Steiner we've been talking about.
In retrospect.
You're not touch that referee. Yeah, he's done it before. He's
I mean, Nash didn't lose to the Giant at Starrcade because he supposedly had a heart attack.
And now Scott Steiner,
like, that's a fact. Like, they called saying that he might have had a heart attack. And then he wrestled weeks later.
Is in trouble here at the hands of Conan.
Gotta make that tag now. Now's a good time if you can get to that corner. Thus far, the teamwork we've seen employed has been all NWO guys.
Yep.
The Wolverines. The
I think Conan's just happy to be in the main event.
There's a foot to the face.
Oh, absolutely.
You talked about the smirk on the face of Kevin Nash. Was it taken away with the $50,000?
I mean, a week ago, Conan wasn't even the tag yet. Now he's in the main event.
He's still not the tag champ, but he'll defend it every week, I'm sure.
Oh,
here he comes.
Oh.
Did that happen yet?
Oh.
Oh, no.
And he throws it.
Yes, sir.
Like two birds, like, floating in the air, trying to mate.
Yeah, they're doing, like, a mating dance, like two peacocks.
That wouldn't have happened if Scott had been in the corner watching, or if he had been close by. He wasn't paying attention.
Have we had a thunder that didn't end in a DQ? Yeah, think about it. Right? Oh no! Oh no!
That's okay, good.
I would like to figure it out.
That's
a clever dance call about a ref.
No!
Oh
my god! I've never seen that before.
And what cause does he have?
Oh, we got a cop.
We got
security,
a cop.
Memphis finest, guys.
Yeah, and WCW security.
Just one cop.
Lock him up, and as the old cliche goes, please follow the key.
He's like, my bad, it was an accident that I powered up him.
Was not always out of his pocket because I don't think...
I hope that referee stays there for 20 like minutes. He better be down the whole rest of until the last family.
Typical white privilege.
Remember, that's the face of the good guy NWO, just a month or two from now, maybe three from now. That's our hero.
What a stupid ending that was.
Yeah.
I hated yesterday's ending.
Oh shit.
The last show's ending.
Yeah.
I hated the Giant just breaking the ring and looking like a dummy. Kevin Nash just makes himself look like a tool every week.
I don't know if you noticed, Kevin Nash has been in the main event of every Thunder. He's the main eventer of Thunder. He's the top guy.
I hate it. Like, I was enjoying this episode until that.
This was a great episode until the end. It's the definition of WCW. The mid-card is awesome, and then the end just falls so flat.
Yeah.
I think the episode before it was better than this one. Like the Jericho, Guerrero, Benoit, and Malenko match obviously was really good, but definitely lost a little bit of steam.
Yeah, I'm just debating if I want to give this one a 2.5 or a 3. I'm like in between the two. It could go either way. Still worlds better than the first
one. Yeah, it wasn't the shits, but so I would say it would be 3. If it was a shits, it'd be definitely a 2.5. But
well, I give the first one a 2. I think this one, yeah, I would say like I'm gonna give it a 2.75. 2.75. I'll split the difference.
Yeah,
that's how I feel. You had a couple good matches. The show flowed really well. Not too many recaps. A really mixed bag of random. You had Ming versus Hacksaw and like. You had fun matchups, but nothing was, like last week you had a lot of matches given good time, and they got to showcase a lot of good stuff. This one, it was a little more quick matches, not a lot of like standouts, but good.
Right.
Aside from the tag match, which was great. Not the main event tag match, the Cruiserweight tag match.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm going to go. It breaks the trend of having every Thunder having gotten better to this point. This one,
right.
I'll give it a 2.75. Coming out of the pay-per-view, that's still a better start than the first Thunder. So maybe it goes up again to the pay-per-view. Who knows?
I don't know. For me, I thought this was still really good. I'd still give it a 3 because there was very little recap. The recap we saw was fun with Sting doing whatever he was trying to do with that Scorpion Splash. Like there was we got Ming and Hacksaw, which I'm not gonna say Ming and Hacksaw was great, but just the thought of Ming and Hacksaw made me happy,
yep.
And that got me through the match. Goldberg destroying Nagata was fun. This episode showed that random grab bag, DDP and Sick Boy, and maybe Sick Boy's only single match ever. There's a lot of uniqueness in this episode, and the Benoit DDP promo at the end was so solid, and it actually got me hyped to see this match, even though I know they're going to be a quality match, just knowing that there's a storyline behind it, it's face versus face, but it feels really genuine. It feels like a real angle to get this newcomer, quote unquote, Benoit to DDP's level. And it's a WCW versus WCW feud, which we've not seen much of these past few years in the WCW programming. There's a lot of great stuff to love. The ending does fall flat. Absolutely. Total shit the last, 10 minutes of this show. But I feel like the rest was still super entertaining. Not quality, but really entertaining.
I think that's
way more entertaining than the first two episodes.
Yeah, I agree. I think I just went a little lower because, like, while I did love the matchups themselves, the matches were, like, there was so much more that could have been done in the actual matches. So it just bumps it down a half of a fraction of a point for me from a 3 to a 2.75. But overall, I am excited for next week. I'm curious how Kevin Nash is going to find himself in the main event with DDP and Benoit, but we'll find out.
Oh, and screw Dusty Rhodes' heel turn, too. Oh. That also brings down a little bit.
Yeah. Forgot about that.
So that justifies it right there.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And not enough Larry Zbysko either.
Yeah. No Larry. No Spicoli either.
All right, hell yeah.
That's true.
Oh, also a disturbing lack of Super Callow. Automatic toy detection.
But we got a tiny bit of disco. We got a tiny bit of disco.
But
so,
that's worse.
There.
That's the opposite.
We got Booker. We got some Booker, though. Tiny bit of Booker team. So there you go.
That's fair.
Yeah, I guess, when you call it all out, you're like, oh, that's actually pretty good matchups. But then it's like, I don't know. For some reason, the last episode had a little more. But yeah, now it's like definitely looking forward to the Benoit DDP. That's the main event, right? For next week? Yeah. So, I mean, if all goes as planned. If all goes as planned.
It's the first time they've set up the next Nitro that I've been excited for.
Right.
Nobody becomes a stepdad by accident. You have to want it, which means heart, determination, and dedication to make that dad bod a father figure. But if you want to be the raddest dad on the block, all you have to do is head over to ProWrestlingTees.com/stepdads to get the official merch of the parental guardians of the galaxy, the stepdads. Do it for your old man and order now.
Now. Yeah. Dude, Ming wrestled Schlack not too long ago in a fucking death match.
I need Ming versus Nick Gage.
Dude, yeah. Yeah, when I saw that, I was like, holy shit. And I watched some of it too. It's just them punching each other over and over again, pretty much.
I just want Ming versus a bunch of just badass. Like, I want Ming versus, like, Manders.
You
want me to be a baby? Just Ming versus Brian Cage.